New Zealand's rainbow community was included in the General Social Survey in 2018 and will be included for the first time in the 2023 census.
We actually start doing what we probably should have been doing for a very long time.
But there's been no research focused on the rainbow Pasifika community.
If you're not seen within research, you're invisible.
When it comes down to it, our communities are the ones who are most likely to suffer violence, most likely to experience things that can end their lives earlier than others.
People in our community live to their 30s and 40s, and they shouldn't have to.
Patrick and Felicia know each other from way back through their families, beauty pageants and dance.
I've always known Patrick, and Patrick's mother and auntie and uncle were three people that were very prominent in supporting a number of whawhawhine.
My mum in particular had a lot of whawhawhine friends, and my uncle is also whawhawhine. And so those are the ways in which we kausi ainga, and for us ainga wasn't just our blood relatives.
They had different experiences growing up in Aotearoa.
I think the hardest part for me was the lonely part, because I didn't see anybody like me. I didn't know anybody like me.
As a child, I was always around whawhawhine. When I was a teenager, I realised that I needed to be strong because I saw how strong people like Felicia was and others around her.
Patrick travelled to study. At home, Felicia supported the Pasifika rainbow community without the data she needed.
What's happened over the last two decades is that we've been expected to access mainstream services. The issues around discrimination that we've experienced has been absolutely, yeah, I don't want to swear, but crap.
Felicia established Fine in 2015, the first Pasifika-led Pacific Rainbow Services organisation, keenly aware that more was needed.
It's been about honouring the experiences, the lived realities that you see, that you live, that you feel.
In 2019, Patrick returned with a PhD from Washington University and took up a postdoctoral fellowship at Auckland University.
My first thought was to contact Felicia because I wanted to be of service to Pacific Rainbow communities in particular. And she said that, well, I've been working in this space for so long, there's still no reliable data for her to be able to influence policy. She needed evidence from the Balangi perspective. We have evidence around us all the time, but that evidence isn't enough for our policymakers.
Supported by the university, Patrick applied to the Health Research Council of New Zealand to fund a project on Pacific Rainbow communities with success.
He had the background, you know, he had all the academic quals to be able to undertake the project, but he also self-identifies with the rainbow community, so it just made complete sense that he would lead this project.
In the past, I don't think people have felt safe enough to be able to come out and say, you know, this is the research I'm doing because I belong to this community. And so what I'm hoping is that people can see that I'm here now, I'm well supported, and I'm making space for others.
The project, named Manalagi, has three parts. Nationwide community consultations to inform a health survey and collection of individual stories.
We saw community members come out and I presented to them, I mihi to them properly, and just hearing their talanoa, their kōrero back at us, it was just such a healing experience. There were so many other people around, both motu, who had similar experiences.
Community feedback led to another survey for family and allies being added, opportunities for creative storytelling and prioritising safety at every step.
We do ask the questions that need to have responses to, data around, like instances of discrimination overt based on rainbow or race or so forth. And so, you know, as a team, we put in sort of safety nets there, and they're able to contact us at any moment if this does become overwhelming. And taking the survey is important, but if they want to be involved in sharing their story through Talanoa, that's also the next phase of the project.
The Manalagi survey is open to people over 15 until August, a pathway for our rainbow community to be seen, heard, and supported.
This is something I hope no longer gives anybody the permission to ignore Pacific, queer, rainbow, LGBTQI+, MVPFAF+ communities and our families.
The outcomes and the recommendations are going to be quite comprehensive and quite robust and authentic.
This isn't just a health survey. This is about uplifting our community's mana and reminding our wider Pacific communities that our mana and their mana is intertwined.
We do this as a collective effort. When I talk about collective effort, it involves our mothers, our fathers, our aunties, our uncles, our brothers, our cousins, our siblings. This is about looking after each other.